Welcome, my beautiful Aries friends. How are you today? Welcome to the channel. Irish Donna Tarot, let's get started with your reading. All right, Aries, this is quite an interesting reading. So I did a 9-card spread, and then I do the clarifiers. And sometimes when 2 cards come out, we just go with it. So this is what I have. The energy between you and your person coming into the reading in the recent past is a relationship that's been very stable, that is marriage-like. It looks as though for most of you, you have been in a committed relationship. I get the 5 of Swords. There has been a period of time now in which the feminine in this relationship has felt very upset with the masculine. And it has created a situation in which the masculine feels as though they have to do something. So now we look at this energy that of the Ace of Wands, that's masculine energy, and we have the 2 Tower cards. So it looks as though in the current energy that there was a lot of disruption in the relationship. The relationship needs a stronger foundation, and under the weight of fighting, and it looks like covert fighting, it doesn't look like it's really a brawl, but we get this really strong sense of Aquarius, I want my freedom, I don't really want to tell you anything, and that doesn't work in a partnership. So we're getting here that the feminine energy felt like the masculine was operating too independently and causing conflict. When we get the Tower card now, Aries, that's your energy. And now we have the Lenormand. These are Lenormand cards, the little ones like this. I'll point them out. Is that in the Lenormand deck, your person realizes that they need to go from a negative tower to rebuilding and creating abundance and stability with you, for you. The Ace of Wands, they're taking action. This is coming as a big surprise to you. So there's no way that you would have actually gone from this energy where you were tempted to break up with this person into this energy of massive overhaul, massive change. And that is very much what's happening in Taurus energy right now. We currently have Taurus with Mars and Uranus. So it's rebuilding energy. It's very powerful right now. The Ace of Coins and the 4 of Wands. Again, this is a marriage card. This is a marriage card. These are long-term commitment cards. It can be up to and including marriage. Many people these days live with each other for years as if they're a married couple. Your person feels as though they need to make a decision, that they need to be very careful because they have the potential to lose you. They have the potential to make the wrong decision. But what I'm seeing here for most of you is someone making you a substantial offer about living in a new place, about that can be a ring. I don't see the engagement party, which makes it an official engagement, but it is stepping up very definitely and definitively to a new level of commitment within your relationship. So this person has devised a plan. They felt as though you were so disenchanted with them that this conflict had caused such a rift between the two of you that you were really feeling as though you were locked out. You had expressed to your person that you felt that you had been left in the cold, that you weren't feeling the same kind of love that this person gave you at the beginning. You are not feeling a sense of stability. I think for many of you, you may have indicated to this person that if things didn't change, that you were very likely to break off the relationship. We get that they view you as a person who is a Queen of Pentacles energy. They view you as like an incredible mother, an incredible worker. You're not going to get anybody more grounded and more dedicated than Queen of Pentacles energy. They see you as fascinating. The Fool card indicates that they want a new beginning with you. And to do that, they have to give you the stability the Queen has, not this idea of leaving you out in the cold by not communicating with you. How they feel in their heart space, Aries. This is phenomenal. This is a crazy good reading. I'm getting this reading. Look at the strength card. That's Leo energy. We have Aquarius. We have all the signs on the deck, so to speak. But your person sees you as their soulmate. They see that they want to be with you. The infinity symbol is part of the strength card. That means they want happily ever after with you. It means that they want to be with you forever. They feel as though you're soulmate. They might feel as though you're twin flames. Here, look at this energy. The Ace of Wands, a masculine energy, taking charge, creating a value in the relationship with you. Again, I think you've been together for a number of years. Six of Cups says that you've known each other a long time. The Seven of Pentacles says, I want to build something substantial with my Aries. This is a plan. This is the action. Look at this. Four of Wands. You don't get a reading like this. This is a very orchestrated plan and display of moving towards solid relationship with you. This person feels as though they've given you reason to feel defensive. They feel defensive, but they want to win. And what we see is that they view the situation as you're the person they want to invest in. So this is already exists, you know. This isn't a decision that has to be made for the future in terms of whether they want you. You are the person they want. The Seven of Wands shows us that this person feels as though they have to defend the relationship. They have to defend you. They have to defend themselves. When we look at the hidden energy here for you, Aries, the hidden energy between you and your partner is this Ten of Wands. The burdens were too heavy. And your person is literally, because now we go from the strength card energy that your person has, this person who's planning, this person who's rebuilding a foundation is revealing themselves to be very, very much the King of Wands, taking action. A person that has a lot of pride, that wants to literally cut your burdens away, and they want to move quite literally, possibly, but mostly, to another place. They feel like the two of you need a new beginning. Both of you feel that way. Your person is taking action, much like a fireman putting out a fire. Coming in, saying, you know, I'm going to replace the fire with value, which is coins. This is a very active plan. This is a strategy. Your person is actively working to win you over. When we look at your outcome card, this person has actually planned how to cut away the burden and create everything around you as this outcome that's going to take away the burden. When we look at what Spirit has to say, Spirit is suggesting you throw caution to the winds, Aries. You know, it's saying the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth is now revealed. The Two of Wands, you may be required to make a decision. We're getting the Nine of Wands. Both you and your partner feel very self-protective. There's some worry here. You're both worried that, you know, it may not work out. But we get the Ace of Cups. Ace of Cups is a new beginning in love. The Star card is hopes and dreams for love coming true. It's an angel on earth. That's how your partner sees you, as a rock star. And the way they want to alleviate your burdens is to give you quite literally a home, a house, a beautiful place to live, someplace that, you know, it appears that both of you have wanted to move away from a particular location, and now your person is looking at a beautiful place for the two of you to live. Now this harkens back to the Four of Wands and the Four of Wands, because this Four of Wands in the Rider-Waite is a bride and groom dancing under the garland at a wedding. The Four is stability. The Four is a marriage. It's a honeymoon. But it very much is a house, quite literally buying a home, you know, making the investment together for stability. So we have this really dynamic time for you, Aries, that is, at this time you are called on to make a decision, and the decision looks like it's a very happy decision for you. Let's look and see what Spirit is recommending you do. If this isn't your reading, at the end of this is a playlist. All the readings are timeless. So if this didn't fit where you're at today, Aries, please check the reading list, the playlist at the end. Be sure to check your Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus, the Moon, Rising, and Venus, because oftentimes your rising sign resonates. All of them resonate with you. Your advice, graceful, be graceful in movement and action. Okay. Grow within your current situation. Oh, Spirit is saying you should stay with your person, that you should grow within the situation, within the relationship that you have. That's going to provide a very wise answer. And it shows, oh, take note of intuitive messages at this time. So Aries, that is your reading. Sending you love from Chicago. It's been a joy since I'm back. Be sure to enter the contest. The details are below. And if you like the content, please subscribe, like, share, comment. Give it a big thumbs up. That tells YouTube that you value the content. Thank you.